I'm Austin Breckenridge for the TDK World Championship.
Top of the pipe in Breckenridge, I had more pressure on myself than ever. It was like, okay, Craig, you've had a title for the last 4 years in a row, starting with the slalom in 86 and 3 years of the overall. It's your last shot at maintaining a world title. I had as good a shot as any American at winning the overall title this year, but my head and my attitude just wasn't into the alpine disciplines this year. I was more into doing the freestyle end of things and spending more time filming and just free riding. The European burn team focuses almost entirely on alpine disciplines. They carve up a storm. They're great racers. And as predicted, the Europeans dominated the alpine disciplines. Waiting for the results after the halfpipe is always hard. For some reason, the announcers keep you in suspense right to the last minute. So when they start announcing the names, they put Keith up there in third. I was like, oh man, I'm second or first. I can't win. What is it? And they announced my name next. And I was like, oh, no, I thought I had it. Palmer had good runs, but I thought I had better ones. I'd won the overall world title for the last 3 years in a row, and this year it was taken over by Mario Paolo Davini from Italy. But I still want to do well in competition. I see myself as having more potential than anybody at winning the title next year.
So you think I've seen everything now, right? Wrong.
The trip to the Soviet Union was special because we had a few riders from different teams. I had Brad Stewart come over from Sims. Wiley Asher, who set the whole thing up, was crazy as ever. And Tom Shea from ISM Magazine was just ripping it up in the powder. And then we had our special guide, Stefan, from Austria, who showed us around the place. Funny to see people covering their faces with gauze or tinfoil, all kinds of stuff to protect their nose from being sunburned. Well, at the same time, they would just drop their pants. Men, women, all of them would drop their pants down to their underwear with their skis still on and try to catch rays on their legs. First thing I see is just big, crowded lift line of chaos in front of me. Everybody was taking their skis off to get to the lift line so you didn't get snaked. And for some reason, I don't know, they didn't know how to ski or didn't know how to board the lift, but everybody kept falling. At one point, one of the lift operators was so fed up with the chaos that he broke out a ski pole and started bonking one guy in the head with it. It was just funny. It was hilarious. People falling off the chairs. It was like the ultimate Warren Miller movie shot.